morning.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. It's good to see you all here on this beautiful Lord's Day that we have together. And one thing that we have learned now from being in Texas for going on our 10th year is as soon as you take the Christmas decorations down around here, it gets cold. We've noticed that just about every year that we've been here. So it's good to see you here. It's chilly outside, but warm inside in your wonderful spirits. Those who are watching online, welcome. Don't blame you, but welcome. We're watching here today together. If you're a guest today, we're especially glad that you are here. There are visitor cards that are in each pew. You can fill that out and put it in an offering plate later. or put it in, or give it to Sonia myself after church today. Right now, I'd like to invite Patty Siltman up to the front. As you know, we have we're working with our ministry architects consultants, and there is a church renovation team, and Patty has an update and a report today for us.
It's on now. Thank you. Okay, glad to see all of y'all here this morning. It was a little challenge hopping out in the car, the cold car. I'm a member, as Pastor Dave said, of the renovation team through Ministry Architects, and we're gonna be giving monthly updates during church time and in the monthly newsletter on our progress of making our church all it can be. So here goes. The reno team, we call ourselves the reno team instead of the renovation team. It sounds a little more fascinating. The reno team meets weekly via Zoom meetings with Sean Williams. Sean is our lead consultant with Ministry Architects. We give our progress made during the week or no progress made during the week. And we get ideas and suggestions from Sean and the other team members. And I don't know if we have a slide showing who the team members are. Okay, there's the team members. And we all have assigned duties. Gerald Ewald and I were working on a guest welcome game plan and ways to track attendance. We want to for everyone to feel very welcome and at home at Friedens Church. We're working on introducing a guest engagement team. They will work with our guests, making them feel a part of our fellowship, letting them know what's going on in our church, where things happen in our church. You know, those of us that have been here forever, we know where people meet. We know where this happens, but not everybody knows that. So if you see an unfamiliar face in the congregation, greet them. We have guest cards in the back of the pew. When we're working on information cards also to make them a little more friendly and maybe not have so much paper in the pews. So just please keep us in your prayers as we move forward. We're all very excited to be on the team, and if you have any questions or comments or concerns, please let us know. We're so open to talk with you. So y'all have a very safe and blessed Sunday.
Sure. Thank you, Patty. Please be in prayer for Patty and Lynn Baumgartner, Jimmy Schriever, Andrea Waite, Steve Locke, and Jerry and Donna Ewald for their continuous work that they'll be doing. And you'll be hearing by next Sunday more about a vision summit that consultants are coming back to town February 24th and 25th. We're going to need your help with this. This is going to kick off some really big, important things for our church. You'll hear more about that by next Sunday. So keep the entire process and everybody involved in your prayers as well. Our church has been involved with a ministry called Compass Cooperative, along with Emmanuel's St. Andrew's Church and Spirit of Joy. We resume tonight. Now, let me say, we're going to attempt to resume tonight. They meet at Spirit of Joy at 6 o'clock. And if we have to postpone that because of the weather, we'll let you know this afternoon by Facebook. But if you don't hear from us, plan on being there tonight. We're kicking off tonight. This is going to be a wonderful time where all the ministers are back, and along with the new leader of Compass 2, they'll be there tonight as well. Now, also along that time, at from six to seven, there is an event for younger children, ages 4 up to 5th grade, at the same time, at the same place. It's called Godly Play, and this is for maybe some of the siblings who need something to be there as well. So both those events at 6 o'clock tonight till 7 at Spirit of Joy Lutheran Church on Dolly Avenue in Seguin. And if we're not having that, we'll post that on Facebook later today. This week, on Friday, January 19th, is the Fish Fry. That's resuming this week. Serving begins at 5 o'clock until the food is gone. It's $15 a plate, which includes the fried fish, french fries, hush puppies, slaw, hot dogs also be available. So come on out this Friday at 5 o'clock for the Fish Fry. Also, too, we have something here at the church in which we have been honoring those who have been married 50 years. So any members who have been married 50 years and have not been recognized during worship service the last couple of years because we had, as they say, hit the pause button for COVID, reach out to our office staff, our church administrator, Kylie, in the church office, or one of the worship life team, which is Teresa Hudson, Patty Seltman, Dinah Locke, Debbie Lowe, Roxanne Wunderlich, about being recognized. So we're trying to recognize all those in February. Now, I will say this. It says anybody's been married 50 years. You can count that as one person, two, three, or four. If it adds up to 50, we'll recognize you. Maybe not. But anyway, that's I thought I'd just throw that in there. I don't know why. It's cold. It's cold today, my friends. I'm trying to get through this. The annual congregational meeting is Sunday, January 28th, immediately following the 10 o'clock a.m. worship service. This is a requirement of the church to have this meeting. There'll be a lot of things on the agenda that day, including the election of those serving on the church council and the ministry boards as well. So that's Sunday, January 28th, right after this worship service. Now, I'm going to get people in trouble. If you've been married to the one person for 50 years, let the worship team know, because now I think it has opened up a whole can of worms there. You know me. So anyway, the Friedens Faith Factory is happening today, right after the children's moment here in worship, and they'll go over with their leaders after that. A couple of other announcements too for us that the flowers today are placed in loving memory of Margaret Brownie on her January 14th birthday by the Bierstadt, Magin, and Cargill families. Beautiful flowers today for Margaret Brownie. The women of Friedens will be handing out thank you offering envelopes today and next Sunday, January 21st. The money you give helps them to fund special projects such as providing gifts for homebound members at Christmas and Easter, and the soup and sandwich meals on Ash Wednesday and Maundy Thursday. Those events are indeed coming up for us as well. So give that your prayerful consideration for the Women of Friedens offering. And the flowers on the organ today are in honor of Patty Seltman's birthday on January 16th by Kathy and the family. So happy birthday. And you have flowers. One more just recognition today. We're just delighted to have Mr. Artie Ritterman. Artie, did you stay around? Yes, you did, Artie. Stayed around. Artie is a longtime resident here. He's been in Montana for the last, how many years have you been there now? 6 years in May. So Artie was on the pastor search committee that had brought Sonia and I here. And he's one of the first ones we ever met here. Artie took us out to Slumber Falls Camp for a tour. And then out here that day, and we certainly missed you. Glad you're doing better, and glad that you're here today, Artie. It's always good to see you. And say hello to the grandchildren, too. Grandchild, okay. Grandchild. Well, say hello to her. Is it a her or a him? It's a her. I got that part right. Okay, to her in Houston. So, Artie, always great to see you, my friend. Glad you're here today. Well, now, my friends, we're going to prepare our hearts and minds for our worship as we begin today. And our first hymn that we will stand and sing together is hymn number 10 in your hymnals, O Worship the King. Let us stand and sing together. Thank you. Please remain standing as Chloe Law comes now to lead us in our call to worship.
Eternal God, source of all wisdom, we praise you.
Open the eyes of our hearts so that we may see your truth.
Risen Christ, you whose world rings true, we greet you.
Open our ears so that we may hear your voice.
Holy Spirit, you whose light shines in us and guides our way, we thank you.
Open our hearts and give us courage to seek your wisdom. Come, Spirit of life, and transform us by your grace.
Our praise song today is My Soul Will Sing, Psalm 103. Let us sing together.
My soul will sing with all the strength I have in me. I will rejoice with every day he gives. I will recall the wonders he has shown to me. His power to heal, his mercy to forgive. We join with angels to sing his praises. He does not treat us as our sins deserve. High as the heavens reach above the earth is your unfailing love, is your unfailing love. For show compassion to the weak, their deepest needs he loves to satisfy. Throughout the earth his justice and his mercy speak, and he will run to meet the victim's cry. From everlasting to everlasting, our youth renewed with every step we take. High as the heavens reach above the earth is your unfailing love, is your unfailing love. Far as the east is banished from the west, you took our sins from us, removed our sins from us. How wide, how wide is your unfailing love. Though we are dust, a moment in eternity, as flowers bloom today and then are gone, he crowns our lives with beauty and with dignity. His patience smiles on all who turn to him. From generation to generation, we'll tell the story of his faithfulness. High as the heavens reach above the earth is your unfailing love, is your
It is because of God's unfailing love that we are able to be here to worship together and to be able to share in the glory of God. Let us greet one another in the name of the Lord. Peace be with you. Greet your neighbors. Let them know you're glad they're here. Peace be with you.
For our children's sermon, all the children can come and join me here at the front. Good morning. How are you? Good to see you all here today. A little chilly today, right? Yes. Who remembers how hot it was last summer, like in August? Remember the heat from last August? Oh, I sure do. That's for sure. We didn't have days like today, did we, back then? But we're here today, and it's good to see you all here. Now, I'll let you in on a little secret. You know a secret? So, Pastor Sonia, her batteries are dead in her microphone. And so she sent Miss Eileen to get some batteries. But then Sonia left two to get the batteries, because that's how people work sometimes. So Eileen, we'll see who gets here first with the batteries. You've got them? Yes. Or Sonia when she walks through the door. So we'll see. Betty has them too? Everybody has batteries but Sonia. That's just amazing. Okay, we'll see who has the batteries first today for Pastor Sonia when she gets back. You think she's coming back? I hope she's coming back. Yes, she's coming back. So today, my friends, this begins the week of the annual Guadalupe Youth Stock Show over in Seguin. Does anybody here participate in that, showing animals or making stuff? We usually have a lot of kids. Some are probably there this morning, maybe. So what we like to do is have a blessing. We have a lot of our youth and families who are part of that every year. And as someone said to me recently, so you always know when it's time for the Youth Stock Show because the weather gets either cold are rainy sometimes, but we like going out there as well. So what we're going to do today is simply have a blessing for all of our young people and for their families on this week with the blessing of the animals and their events. We have people who spend just hours and hours and hours and days and weeks and months and a long time helping with this. So we're going to do that today. We have two folks who are part of that today, Ava Clark and Rylan. Everyone Trost is here. Come on down. They're going to help us. Did you find your batteries?
Yes.
She says yes. She's found the batteries. Who all has batteries today? Just want to make sure we have several. Yes, the batteries today. So in our blessing time today, we're going to do this. So Ms. Ava and Ms. Rylan is going to help do this with me today. So Rylan, what are you? How are you participating in the stock show this year?
I'm showing rabbits at the stock show.
You're showing rabbits at the stock show?
Yes, sir.
All right. Furry ones, I hope, with thick fur for this week. Yes. How about Ava? What are you showing this year?
I show lambs.
She shows lambs. How many years have you shown lambs?
Probably five, I think, now.
5 years of showing lambs. What else have you shown at the stock show?
I've also showed heifers, pigs, and rabbits.
Rabbits. That's wonderful. So you've been at this a long time. What else have you shown, Rylan, at the stock show other than rabbits?
I've also done a baked good.
That's right, yes. Last year you did that, didn't you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it was fantastic. So we're going to pray for them and all this week and the families who will spend hours out there trying to stay warm and get the animals ready for the big show for this year. So this is a blessing for them, okay? So hear these words, and I'll start today, and Rylan and Ava are going to help as well. Dear loving God, we thank you for being present with us in everything that we do.
We ask that you bless each young person participating in the Guadalupe County Youth Show this week. Much hard work gone into preparing this event. Thank you for parents, families, and friends that provided support in the whole process.
And we ask that you bless the animals that will be shown and help them to be well rested and in good health.
Please guide the youth that are showing animals, submitting baked goods, needlework, and handcrafts. May they feel confident in their abilities. Grant them each with them a sense of patience, peace, and courage. Holy God, thank you for the opportunity of the youth participating in the youth show to share gifts and abilities that you have given them. May they learn from this experience and experience leadership skills that will help them in all life.
May all that we do bring glory to your name, O God. Amen. Both Ryland and Ava are very involved in FFA and 4-H, and they go all over the place. One of my first events, boy, Artie, you came on the right day, didn't you? One of the first events I ever did here when we lived here was meet Artie for his FFA group there at Seguin High School a number of years ago. So that was wonderful, too. How many here have something or have something with the Guadalupe Youth Show, either this year or years past? How many? Go ahead and raise your hands. There's a lot of people here in this church who've been a part of that over the years. So blessings on everyone, and thank you. So yes, we bless the animals, we bless the participants, and we bless you guys too, and for all that you do as well in your life. And remember, boys and girls, how much God always loves you. Certainly. It's good to see you here today. There is Sunday school today with Ms. Vicki, if you want to go to Sunday school. And, of course, there is a nursery for children 5 years old and younger, too, with Ms. Lauren there in the back, too. And parents, you can pick up your children after church today. It's good to see you, my friends. We'll see you later. Bye-bye.
The choir, can you turn on my mic? Thank you. Now that I finally got batteries in, sorry about that. Well, I had batteries, but they died. So I wanted to share with you, the choir is not singing today. However, we do have our praise band that's going to share with us a new song that you're all going to be learning, and it's entitled Rejoice.
Rejoice in the Lord and in always, sing it again, we rejoice. Delight in the love of his shown us, gratefully lift up your voice. His gentleness among us, join our hearts with praise. We gather in his goodness, the family of grace, with his breath. Praise the Lord. Rejoice in the Lord and always tell of the good he has done. Worship the Lord and remember all of the joy yet to come. The hope that burns within us, darkness cannot destroy. With praise that's never ending, say again.
One of the great joys we have in a life of faith, as we know through Jesus Christ and of God, is our opportunity to pray to God. There is a God that hears our prayers, knows our hearts and minds, the God that is with us. And in our communion with God, we do that through prayer. And God can speak to us too through God's Spirit to help us and guide us and lead us each and every day. It is God's Spirit that indeed wants to be a part of our lives too, if we avail ourselves of that each and every day. And I pray that we always will. So in our prayer time today, we list our prayer concerns as a church in our weekly bulletin, also in our monthly newsletter as well. And of course, we take prayer requests each week too, when you write those down for us and submit that to us as well. So prayer is important. It's vitally important. All through the Bible, we find of God's people praying to God and seeking God. And of course, Jesus prayed as well often with groups, and often with by himself. So I want us to be known, too, as a praying people in all of our lives. So now will you join me in our prayer today? Oh, Holy God, we give you thanks that we can gather here in this place. And we do give you thanks that it is a warm and dry place that we can gather in your name. And through your love and grace, we do have indeed the warmth of hearts and minds and souls with us here and wherever we go. We give you thanks, O God, for your great love in our lives and in this world. We give you thanks each day for your mercies and your grace that we live in and through. Help us to share that with others, O God. And on those days of trouble, O Lord, let us know that you are with us, that you are here, and that you show us the way, you guide us through your Spirit. And on those days, too, O Lord, perhaps where we are trying to find help for others, may we have strength for all of our tasks that we have in all of life. We give you thanks for all the good things that happen in this church and through these members and their families, through their communities and schools, wherever they may live and work and wherever they may be. Help us to be that light into the world, O God, ourselves, as Jesus was the light of the world. And help us to live out the prayer that Jesus has taught us to say, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Our offertory hymn today is hymn number 466 in your hymnals. And as he leadeth me, let us stand and sing this hymn together as we prepare now for our offering today.
He leadeth me.
grabbed the wrong thing. Will you join me in our prayer of illumination? Dear God, give eyes to see, ears to hear, and hearts and minds to understand your word. Amen. I'm reading from the Gospel of John in the first chapter, verses 43 through 51. The day Jesus decided to go to Galilee, he found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Now Philip was from Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found him about whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus, son of Joseph from Nazareth." Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." When Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward him, he said of him, "Here is truly an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." Nathanael asked him, "Where did you get to know me?" Jesus answered, "I saw you under the fig tree before Philip called you." Nathanael replied, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered, "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under the fig tree? You will see greater things than these." And he said to him, "Very truly, I tell you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." Hear what the Spirit is saying. Thanks be to God. I enjoy meeting new people. My personality type is an extrovert, which means I get energy from being around people. I'm a very people person, sometimes, except when people are very people-y. But I am outgoing. Yet there's always a part of me that is a bit hesitant, cautious. What if that person I'm meeting is not trustworthy? What if they intend to harm me? What if they don't like me? I believe it's human nature to be a bit hesitant, even cautious about meeting a stranger for the very first time. Amy Cuddy, a psychologist at the Harvard Business School, has studied first impressions for more than a decade. She and her colleagues found that we make snap judgments about other people that answer two primary questions. One, can I trust this person? And two, can I respect this person's capabilities? According to Cuddy's research, 80 to 90% of a first impression is based on these two traits. Subconsciously, you and the people you meet are asking yourselves, can I trust this person has good intentions towards me? And is this person capable? Trust and capability. According to the Journal of Neuroscience, the brain immediately determines how trustworthy a face is before it's fully perceived, which supports the fact that we make very fast judgments about people. Even some Christian ministers agree with this idea of trust and capability. According to Christian teacher and theologian Richard Rohr, quote, "The most common human responses to a new moment, such as meeting new people, are mistrust, cynicism, fear, defensiveness, dismissal, and judgmentalism." We see this idea of judging people based on trustworthiness and capability in this passage from the Gospel of John. Andrew and Peter are invited to meet Jesus, and after they meet him, they're immediately asked to follow him. Andrew knew about Jesus because John the Baptist and Simon Peter knew about Jesus, also because of Andrew's introduction. Their trust seems to come from knowing others who knew of Jesus. At the beginning of this scripture passage, Jesus invites Philip to follow him. Now, we don't read of any hesitation or mistrust. Perhaps it's because Philip is from the same town as his friends, Andrew and Peter, who introduced him. However, this doesn't seem to be the case with Philip's friend Nathanael, who was a follower of John the Baptist as well. Philip is eager to share about Jesus with Nathanael, that Nathanael responds to the invitation without ever meeting Jesus face to face in a very skeptical and judgmental manner by saying something, "This is an insult. Can anything good come from Nazareth?" Why this judgmental, narrow-minded statement? Well, location seems to factor into our ideas about certain kinds of people. For example, when I've shared with some folks that I'm originally from the southwestern part of Virginia, I have been asked if I am a hillbilly. And if so, do I know how to make moonshine? If I did know how to make moonshine, do you think I would share that bit of information with you? And if living in the mountainous region of Virginia makes me a hillbilly, then I am proud to say I am. Yes, often what we say about a location is meant to be playful and funny, yet sometimes it isn't intended to do so. Nathanael isn't making a joke here. Location is key. He wants to know that if this is the Messiah that he has been waiting for, and he wants to know if this Messiah is from what he terms as a credible place. Nazareth was held in low esteem by those outside the village. It was a small, quiet community. And in the eyes of the so-called educated and urban Jews, such as Nathanael, the Nazarenes would have been judged as ignorant at best. Now, we must understand how their faith tradition informed the Jewish beliefs of that time. Many Jews believed that the Messiah, who was called, would be a military leader. He would be someone with much power and prestige who would overthrow the Roman government and take control. It would not be a peaceful event. It would be violent. Yet Jesus wasn't about overthrowing a government. He wasn't about creating a church state. Nathanael took this Messiah stuff seriously. He wasn't the only one that had the expectation of a glorious and triumphant Messiah. How could this humble, quiet man from Nazareth be the king of Israel? Instead of challenging Nathanael's judgmental ideas, Philip invites Nathanael by simply saying, "Come and see," using the exact same phrase that Jesus had used earlier with Simon Peter and Andrew. Jesus looks beyond the exterior of Nathanael's ideas and his judgmental attitudes. He looks into Nathanael's heart. He sees what his faith is about. And it isn't long before Nathanael understands what Philip was trying to tell him. Jesus is the Messiah, the one they have been hearing about and waiting for all their lives. Biblical scholars speculate that what Jesus says about seeing Nathanael under a fig tree fulfills a prophecy that is found in the Old Testament, where prophet Zechariah used the imagery of the vine and fig tree to speak about a Messiah who would come and save Israel. Language and symbols, imagery, are important. They have meaning. But whatever the reason, Nathanael's mind and heart are open to see Jesus as the true Messiah. In fact, he confesses his belief of Jesus as the Son of God, even before the other disciples that follow confess him as Son of God. Jesus does challenge Nathanael by saying to him in a matter of words, if you think this is great, wait until you see the great things that God and I have for you and for the world. When Jesus says to Nathanael, "You will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man," he is making a connection with the faith tradition that they share. It was their ancestor, Jacob, Remember Jacob? He was out running away from Esau, his brother, who we know he had offended and taken, stolen his birthright. He is scared and he is running. But he stops and he goes to sleep and he has a dream where there was a stairway or a ladder. You've heard that song, "We Are Climbing Jacob's Ladder." But it is connected to the earth, to the top of heaven. And the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. This dream meant that earth and heaven were united, and God would be faithful to God's promises to Jacob and his descendants, of whom Jesus and Nathanael are both descendants of Jacob. Jesus promises Nathanael that he will experience God's glory. The invitation to follow Jesus, the invitation to come and see a Messiah, is much more than what we might see before us. We will not truly experience the fullness of God's glory until we leave the bonds of this earth. However, in the meantime, believers are able to encounter glimpses of God's glory if they're open to how God's glory shows up. When Jesus spoke personally to Nathanael, God's glory was present. Jesus didn't approach Nathanael saying, "Why don't you believe I am the Messiah? Why are you talking bad about my hometown? How can I convince you that I am the anointed one?" No, Jesus approached Nathanael and love. He understood Nathanael's doubt and skepticism. He didn't become defensive. He connected with Nathanael. He was relational. And that is one way that God's glory is manifested, is through God's love. Unconditional love. No strings attached, no conditions to meet. Pure, unconditional love. God's glory is manifested, made apparent often. We just need to be open to it and aware of it. God's glory is present when we worship together, when we sing, when we pray and listen to God's word together. God's glory is present when we do acts of service, when we help another, when we comfort the grieving, when we feed the hungry, when we provide shelter, when we are simply present with others. God's glory shows up in the most unexpected ways through people, animals, nature, art, and locations. Think of your happy place, if you have a happy place. God's glory is there. And I encourage those that will be out at the youth show this week, look for God's glory to show up, because it will. When we have certain expectations about God and God's glory, we may actually miss out on God's glory being revealed to us. Think of when Jesus was born, which we just celebrated. What if signs of God's glory had been ignored? What if the shepherds had ignored the announcement of the angels to come and worship the newborn king? What if the three magi had not followed the star to worship Jesus? Or better yet, gone back to tell Herod where Jesus was, and then Jesus would have been killed? No, they followed. They allowed God's glory to be revealed to them. They recognized it. We are given opportunities to encounter God's glory. And if we are not encountering God's glory, we may want to look at our expectations, our skepticism, even our prejudice. What are we looking for? Even Jesus asked that. What are you looking for? Who are you looking for? How are we keeping ourselves from seeing and experiencing God's glory? I believe an important way we can encounter God's glory is when we invite others to come and see Jesus. When we invite others to church, we are inviting them to come and see the difference Jesus is making in our lives through the ministries of this church, Friedens Church. How Jesus is teaching us the way of love and doing the long, hard work, and how to do everything in love. We can encounter God's glory here at Friedens Church when we seek Jesus together, when we serve together. Each Sunday when we are here at Friedens Church, I encounter God's glory in conversations, in handshakes and hugs, in tears and laughter, in children of all ages, in the silence, and in the singing. I encounter God's glory in the architecture, these beautiful stained glass windows in particular, and the farmland that surrounds this area, along with the cows that often greet me across the fields. God's glory is in the sunrises and the sunsets. And God's glory is in the night sky filled with what must be a million stars. If we open ourselves to the idea that God desires for us to encounter the glory of God, then we will in small and grand ways. And one day, when we leave the bonds of this earth, we will encounter the full glory of God that is beyond our human imaginations. As Jesus said, set your mind on divine things, heavenly things. And when we do so, expecting daily to encounter God's glory, then we are better equipped to face the painful and dark times of life, better able to be of support and of encouragement to others when they are struggling on the journey, helping others to encounter God's glory, letting them know that things will get better, helping them see the signs of God's love along the way. And one day, if we come and see and believe in Jesus Christ, we will see greater things than these. Let us pray. Gracious and holy God, we thank you for the story of Nathanael and his skepticism and his judgmental attitude. We learn, God, that can block us from seeing your glory. But you will work to get through all that stubbornness and the barriers that we put up to let us see your light. Guide us, oh God, to look for your glory in each other, in the world around us, in our worship, in the way in which we live our lives. May it all bring glory to you. We thank you, O God, for your love and grace that makes it all possible to live this life. It is in your name I pray. Amen. Our closing psalm this morning is Here I Am, Lord. This speaks of a time when Samuel was a young man and he heard the call of God in the Old Testament. And he hears this voice and it is the call of God. And he responds, may we respond to serve God in our lives. Please stand as we sing.
Dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to him? Whom shall I send? Here I am.
In fact, I think that was sung at my ordination to ministry, and also I think when we had our installation here. It's such a beautiful song that speaks of the calling that God has on our hearts to serve, no matter if we're clergy or lay persons that are serving, all are ordained and called to serve by Jesus. All you have to do is answer when he says, come and see and follow me. Well, thank you so much for being here today with us. You braved the elements. I know it's going to get worse. It's only a couple days, folks. We'll be fine. It's going to be all right. It's going to be okay. There'll be others who have much worse weather than we are this week, so be in prayer for them as well. But I pray for everyone, and may we stay warm. Also, reminder about Compass. If we do not have it this evening, we will send out a message to those that normally do try to comment on Facebook. We have our new intern leader who will then become our official leader in the summer, Hannah Hansen, and she is a senior at Texas Lutheran, wonderful young woman. And so we're so excited, and she's going to be here on the last Sunday of this month to meet you all. I hope you'll be here to meet Hannah and welcome her. She will be circulating through our church probably once a month or less. I don't know. It depends on what the schedule is going to be. But you'll see her around, and encourage your young people, 6th through 12th grade, to come, because we have a lot of fun. We always have good food and fellowship, only 6 to 7 p.m. on Sunday evenings, and also with godly play for those that are 5th grade and younger to 4 years of age. So a lot to offer out there for everyone. So let us strive to live simply, love generously, serve faithfully, speak truthfully, pray daily, and leave everything else to God. Amen. Hey, Wilfred. Good morning. I missed you yesterday. I was out there before you got out there at camp. You were there for dinner, weren't you?
Yes.
Yeah, I came out for a couple hours yesterday. It's good to be there. Yeah? Yeah, it is. Thank you for leading today. How are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. Very good. Thanks. Hey, Katie, how are you?
Good job.
Well, thank you. Hey, I was going to tell you, I want to make sure your mom hears this too, and the whole world.